Anderson Cooper is keeping them honest. AC 360, CNN weeknights, 8 Eastern.
On the night of August 11th, teenagers in Steubenville, Ohio, gathered to celebrate the end of the summer. The first day of school was just 2 weeks away. By many accounts, there was heavy drinking going on for most of the night, spread out over several different parties. But there may have been more than that, far more. Tweets, photos, and videos possibly document a crime from that night, an alleged sexual assault of a seemingly intoxicated, unconscious, underage teenage girl by members of the high school football team, an assault that other partygoers allegedly watched and later shared details online. This tweet from a partygoer reads, "Song of the night is definitely Rape Me by Nirvana." Other tweets call the girl sloppy and talk about a dead body, referring to the girl's state of unconsciousness. One tweet even refers to the fact that the girl may have been urinated on, though police say there's no evidence that actually happened. 3 days after the party, the girl's mother came forward to the police and filed a report alleging sexual assault. She came with a computer drive showing a Twitter page and other possible evidence, according to police. Many of these postings were soon taken down. The police chief in Steubenville told CNN he asked for any witnesses to come forward with details of what they saw that night, but initially only two did.
So that's how the first two arrests were made within the first 2 weeks. We have witness statements there, but I mean, as far as anybody else being involved, nobody else has come forward.
On August 22nd, two 16-year-old members of the football team, Trent Mays and Malik Richmond, were arrested. They were later charged with rape, and Mays was also charged with disseminating photographs of a nude minor. By December, the incident had created a fissure in the community. Some came to the boys' defense, saying they were unfairly and too quickly accused. Others were relieved, tired, they said, of the anything-goes culture for the popular football players.
You're a football player, you get to do what you want as long as you got a winning season.
May's lawyer denied a rape occurred, saying he will challenge whether any possible sexual activity was consensual. Alexandra Goddard, a blogger and former Steubenville resident, started looking into this story after hearing that high school football players were involved. Goddard found most of the online postings and reposted them to her website before they were taken down.
I went through the Twitter accounts and I found, you know, very disturbing messages, basically laying out a timeline of what happened that evening, and found the cache of the YouTube video. Just found all of the social media which told the story of what happened that night.
May's lawyer told CNN it's his client who has been tried unfairly online and that he will be exonerated once all the facts come out.
Greetings, citizens of the world. We are Anonymous.
On December 23rd, the internet hacker group Anonymous got involved, threatening to release information on the high school football players involved in the incident unless a public apology was made to the alleged victim by January 1st.
We will not sit idly by and watch a group of young men who turn to rape as a game or sport get the pass because of athletic ability and small-town luck. You now have the world looking directly at you.
Anonymous posted this picture online, showing a girl whose face is blurred, who is seemingly unconscious, being carried by her hands and feet by two males. It's not possible to verify the photo is of the alleged victim, but the defense attorney for one of the accused, Malik Richmond, confirmed to CNN his client is in the photo, but said the image is taken out of context.
That young lady is not unconscious. That young lady was capable of walking, and her friends are individuals who indicated that information to the police.
This 12-minute video also surfaced online, where teens appear to talk about the alleged assault and continually joke about the girl's condition, even at one point saying she must have died because she didn't move during the alleged rape.
Hey, what if that was your daughter?
But it isn't.
What?
If that was my daughter, I wouldn't care. I'd just let her be dead.
The trial for the two boys accused of rape is scheduled for mid-February. Poppy Harlow, CNN, Steubenville, Ohio.